fed a ton of weapon DLC within Black Ops 3, and of course, a lot of people genuinely enjoy it while others don't necessarily because it's only in supply drops, but whatever side of the coin you end up dropping on, supply drop weapons are a thing that are in the game. And one thing that's been around since the very birth of Black Ops 3 is the idea that some weapons are still hidden within the game files, and the two that are the most notorious within Black Ops 3 are the MP7 and the M27. And this is something that for ages, since the beta, people have been saying the MP7 and the M27 will in fact end up coming to Black Ops 3 as DLC weapons. And to this day, we've still yet to see them. So where are they, and will they ever end up being released for Black Ops 3? Now, as it stands, as of this right now making this video, there's still a few months left in Black Ops 3 before Call of Duty World War II is in fact released, so it is possible we get one, maybe two more weapon drops within DLC supply drops for Black Ops 3 and the weapon content coming throughout this remaining time period. But what is unlikely to me is the fact that those weapons will include the M27 or the MP7. And in this video, we're gonna be talking about why, because personally, I don't think that we'll ever see these guns in Black Ops 3, and for some good reason. So let's start all the way back at the beginning, the beta for Black Ops 3. August of 2015 is upon us at this point, and it's something where everybody's amped up because they can finally play the long-awaited first beta in Call of Duty since, I believe, what it was, World at War. So years have gone by since anybody's gotten to play Call of Duty this early on, and for a new title, it's of course something everybody's amped up about that as well. Now, with the PlayStation 4 beta, things come and go, everybody's hyped up about that, but things really start to get interesting with the Xbox One and PC beta, because if any of you guys know how the PC works, you can access game files. You can end up going into the actual raw data that the game is built on and take a look at some things that aren't necessarily meant to be there just yet. Some builds absolutely must have some things that can't be hidden, and as a result, some things get leaked a little early compared to when they should be revealed. And such things included a handful of weapons and a specialist weapon even at that when this went live at the beta. So those things being the flamethrower, which was the specialist weapon for the purifier, which we actually didn't even know of at the time, that was actually completely withheld from the beta, but it was still there as its specialist weapon form. Then there was the power bolt, which was the SVG, but codenamed differently, and was something that was not in the beta at the time as well. But then it came down to a few other things, that being that the MP7 and the M27 were found in the game code. Now, this is where the whole weapon DLC speculation really stems from, because it was there in the game files, why is it not there at this point or in the future? Simply because they were never meant to be in Black Ops 3. Now, of course, the whole idea of the fact that these could be weapons left over in the game code from Black Ops 2 do apply, but truthfully, these were actually base weapons for the models that are currently in the game, those being the Pharaoh as well as the ICR. Now, for even further proof of this, if you ended up ever taking a look at some footage from the MP7 that was actually forcefully applied into the multiplayer version of PC during the beta, you'll be able to see the actual weapon asset name on your HUD instead of where it would say similarly MP7 or Pharaoh or ICR or anything like that. But the MP7, whenever actually placed into multiplayer, would display a name of weapon_SMG_burst. Now that is a perfect alignment for that of the Pharaoh, because the Pharaoh is that of a burst SMG. Additionally, when you take a look at the weapon properties, when you take a look at the size of the weapon, the model itself, the reload animation, everything like that is a basic building block from the MP7 from previous titles. And thus, since they come from the same core files, it's not something where we'd end up seeing a split and seeing a second identical weapon, essentially just an automatic version. Now, if you want to take a look at the ICR as well, that is something that once again is derived from the M27, and even further ending up taking a look as to why this would not end up being something in the game files, there's not even a magazine for the M27 coded in there. anything that you end up seeing within the M27 always has a magazine missing, and therefore it does not have the capabilities to fire any projectiles, which, yes, is as simple as adding in a magazine, but it's been withheld for a specific reason. And again, as such, it's just the basic building blocks for that of what went on to become the ICR. So when you have, once again, these base models of weapons that are now current models in Black Ops 3 for weapons, it's not something where you'd end up splitting them off and putting in another one as a result. And while the M27 has a little bit of a less strong case for it, the MP7, if you once again were to ever look at those game files, with it being designated as the weapon_SMG_burst, that to me just shows that not only is it not meant to be there, but it's also just the basic building block. So to me, we're never going to end up getting the MP7 or the M27, which, as much of a bummer as it may be to some people, it may be better off this way. But that said, that's sort of gonna wrap it up. Just wanna let you guys know, because I've been seeing quite a bit of chatter about future DLC weapons within Black Ops 3, and honestly, this has been going on for quite some time. So I figured I'd just address it here, put the record straight, I think, or at least what I believe the record is straight. Right now, there's nobody that's ever come straight out and said, this is exactly what it is from the development team, but all signs point to this. And hopefully you guys understand where I'm coming from as well with this. But let me know your thoughts down there in the comment section down below. Would you guys like the MP7 and M27 from Black Ops 2 to return within Black Ops 3? Or do you not necessarily care at all? Or whatever it may be, feel free to drop it down there. But hopefully you guys enjoyed. And if you guys did, make sure you drop a like down below. And of course, if you guys are new to the channel as well, make sure you guys subscribe to stay up to date with everything we have here regarding Black Ops 3, both multiplayer and zombies. Call of Duty World War 2 with multiplayer and zombies there as well. Modern Warfare Mastered and Infinite Warfare, all that good stuff. We got you covered here up on the channel. And finally, if you guys want to follow me over on Twitter, that is the best place to get connected with me outside of YouTube. Practically live on Twitter, so if you guys want to strike up a conversation, ask me a question, whatever it may be, link is down there in the description below. For all that said and out of the way, hope you guys have a fantastic day. Thanks so much for watching. My name is Espresso. I'll see you guys later. Take care and peace.